So if there's like a, because I know you deal with a lot of like the C-suite level and then the upper executive level, Joe, but I'm sure there is collaboration and it has to be cohesive between all levels, all the way down to the workers. If someone like in middle management or supervisor role says, I'm seeing this, how do I approach my executive team? What should they say? What would you advise someone who's listening and they're like, okay, this is resonating with me, and we need to take action because I'm seeing low productivity with the people I manage. I'm a supervisor. What should that supervisor say to really get the leadership team to take action?
So I think there's three levels to look at this at. One is, what are you noticing beneath you, right? When you look at the folks you're managing, really pinpoint exactly what it is you're observing and have some data to back it up, right? To say whether it's sales performance or whether it's net promoter scores from your customer service team, or if you're a marketing leader, right? Trends that we're not capturing, but bring data to the conversation, I think is so critical, right? Because people respond much better to, I don't know, what could be viewed as a complaint or maybe someone highlighting a negative, right? When you have data to back it up. Two would be to look at your own optimal leadership style and your delivery style and say, what comes natural to me as an influencer? How should I deliver this data, right? If you're a person who's more of a persuader by nature, don't try to deliver it in a way that doesn't come off as natural, because people will see right through that, right? And then lastly, and this is so important and something I've been noticing more, is when middle management is trying to go to senior management and say, hey, I think we have a problem, right? The Houston, we have a problem call. The step that they're skipping and why they're not getting as much buy-in is, one, they're not bringing the data, right? So you got to bring the data. But two, paint a picture of success. Don't just talk about the problem. Come with, and here's what I think the solution could look like. Because even if your compass isn't necessarily 100% right, you need to show what part of the solution could look like to show that you're forward thinking, right? You're someone who is thinking about future success. You're someone who is a not just an identifier of problems, but someone who is going to invest themselves in the solution. And if you do that, and if you can paint a picture of what success looks like, you're also taking some of the heavy lift out for senior leadership. So they're not looking at this as, oh my God, now I got to do all this work. Wow, Joe, come, they're going to bring me what that solution could look like. And they're going to help take some of that lift off because we've so much else going on. And so I think if you do it from those three lenses, data, my delivery style, and then talk about what success looks like, I think you're going to get more traction with senior leadership when you identify something that could be fixed.